Hello students, welcome to Dynamics of Machinery. In the previous class, we have solved a problem from several masses rotating in several planes. Actually, we are in third module. Third module deals with flywheel. One portion deals with the flywheel, particularly turning moment diagram of flywheel. That is one portion, and one more portion is balancing. Balancing of rotating masses. Balancing of reciprocating masses. Okay, this is what third module is all about. In the previous classes, we have solved several problems for rotating of masses in single plane, rotating of several masses in several planes. Okay, two cases we have solved. Okay. In this class, we are going to solve a problem about rotating. Balancing of reciprocating mass. In the previous class, we have solved a problem for balancing of rotating mass. Okay. In this class, we are going to solve a problem for balancing of reciprocating masses. Okay. One more thing, balancing of reciprocating masses. Here we will have three cases: inline cylinder. Okay. Then. Two cases. In balancing of reciprocating masses, we have two categories. One is inline cylinder, another one is V engine. Okay. First, let us go through some basics. In the second module, while we are studying about dynamic forces, okay, we are studying about dynamic forces. Static equilibrium and dynamic equilibrium. In the second module, we have studied about dynamic equilibrium. Okay, there we have studied about these things: forces acting on the members of IC engine. Okay, suppose if there is a IC engine, means here in dynamic study we will be considering the inertia force. Okay, suppose in this case. Piston try to move in this direction. Okay. So if a piston try to move in this direction, means in the opposite direction, inertia force will be acting. Okay. In the opposite direction, inertia force will be acting, and this FR, it is a force required to move the piston. Okay. Towards the required direction. So this is Fi means inertia force, Fn means force on the side, okay, and Fb means force acting on the crankshaft bearings. Okay. So whenever inertia force comes, it might create a unbalancing in the system. Whenever inertia force comes, the inertia force is the itself a unbalanced force. Okay, so we have to balance the system by applying some external loads. Suppose if inertia effect is zero, means there is no inertia force, means no unbalanced force in the system. But definitely there's a chance for couple, unbalanced couple. Okay. Even though there is no inertia force, so no inertia force means no unbalanced force, but unbalanced couple will be there. Okay. So we have to balance this unbalanced force. We know the formula for inertia force. F equal to ma, mass into acceleration, where acceleration, formula for acceleration is omega r into omega square r into cos theta plus cos 2 theta divided by n. Now we will split this set bracket. So split this set bracket. Okay, if we split means what we'll get? MR omega square cos theta plus MR omega square cos 2 theta by n. So this first term is called primary unbalanced force. This second term is called secondary unbalanced force. That's all. Okay, MR omega square cos theta is primary unbalanced force. MR omega square cos 2 theta by n is the secondary unbalanced force. First, let us solve a problem from V engine. Okay. Here they are given a V engine. Let me read the question first. A V twin engine has a cylinder axis at right angles and the connecting rods operate at a common crank. This is reciprocating masses. So they are given a mass value 11.5 kg and the crank radius R value 75 mm. Length of connecting rod L value 0.3. So that the engine may be balanced for primary forces by means of this revolving balancing mass. So by applying some external balancing mass, we have to balance it. Okay. So that we have to prove here. How much mass we have to apply? Like that they are asking. If the engine speed is 500 rpm, what is the maximum? What is the value of maximum resultant secondary force? So how much unbalanced secondary force will be there? That's what they are asking. So there are formulas for primary unbalanced force. Formula is see. Previously we have seen. For primary unbalanced force, formula is MR omega square cos theta R cos square. Here MR omega square cos 2 theta divided by N. This is what we have seen here. But for V engine, small changes. 2 MR square into root of cos square alpha into cos theta whole square. Sin square alpha into sin theta whole square. Yeah. Here alpha means angle between the engines. So here they are given two engines. Okay, they are perpendicular to each other. They are perpendicular to each other. So alpha means, sorry, this angle is 2 alpha. Okay, this angle is 2 alpha. 2 alpha equal to 90 degree means alpha will be equal to 45 degree. Okay, mass value 11.5 kg, radius value 75 mm, put everything in meter, so 0.075 meter, L value 0.3 meter, and speed 500 rpm, so omega equal to 2 pi n by 60, so 52.37 radian per second. Now let us write the formula. Okay, now let us write the formula. So after substituting everything, here you have to put cos 45 degree, here sin 45 degree, okay. Cos 45 means 1. Cos 45 means answer is 1. Okay. Sorry. Sorry. Cos 45 means 1 by 2. Okay. 1 by root 2. Cos 45 means. Cos 45 means. 1 by root 2. Okay. Sin 45 also 1 by root 2. Okay. What they are given? They are given cos square 45. So cos square 45 means 1 by root 2 the whole square. Sin square 45 means 1 by root 2 the whole square. So the answer will be 1 by 2. Here also 1 by 2. So put this value here. So cos theta by 2. Okay. So here also sin square 45 means 1 by 2. So sin theta divided by 2. Okay. Instead of cos square 45, I have put the answer 1 by 2. Instead of sin square 45, I have put the answer 1 by 2. Now, so in common we have one by two is common here. So take the one by two out. Okay, if you take one by two out, means you will get one by two the whole square like this. Then what you will have inside? Cos square theta plus sine square theta. You know cos square theta plus sine square theta equal to 1. Okay, cos square theta plus sine square theta equal to 1. So it will become root of 1 by 2 the whole square. So if you take out, means you'll get one by two cancel. Finally, you will get MR omega square. Okay. So FP value is MR omega square. So MR omega square means it is a it means the system is balanced. Primary force is balanced because the inertia force value also MR omega square. So it is balanced. Okay. Sorry, the rotating the revolving force value, when the piston revolves, it also create the force MR omega square. So both of them cancel each other. So there is no primary force. That's why in the question they didn't tell us to find. Here they asked only maximum resultant secondary force. They didn't ask primary force, because primary force value is MR omega square. MR omega square means there is no unbalanced force. The meaning is there is no unbalanced force. Let us move to the second equation. For secondary balanced force, force, the formula is root 2 into m by n into mr omega square divided by n into sine 2 theta. Okay, we have to find out maximum secondary force. When sine 2 theta will be maximum? When sine 2 theta will be maximum? That we have to find. Okay. So when you get plus or minus 1, at that time Fs will be maximum. When you will have 1 as answer? When sine 90 means answer will be 1. Okay, so 2 theta equal to 90. So theta value should be 45. When theta value is 45 or 135, you will get answer as 1 or minus 1. Okay, at that time Fs value will be maximum. So put theta equal to 45 degree. If I put 45, means this term will be cancelled. Okay, because sine 90 equal to 1. So we can leave that term. Remaining what we have? We have root 2 m by n. Otherwise we can tell like that. Root 2 by n into m r omega square. See, for primary we had the answer as m r omega square. Okay. But here we got root 2 by n into mr by mr omega square. Suppose here also if you got mr omega square, means we can say there is no unbalancing force here. But here we have this extra term, root 2 by n. What is n? N means L by R. Okay, put the value of L and put the value of R inside and you will get the value of n. So substitute it here. Substitute all the values. Root 2, m value is 11.5, L value is 0.3, R value is 0.075, and omega value is 52.37 and the radius value is 0.075. Final answer is 836 meter. That's all. Only two formulas. Only two formulas in V engine. This formula and then this formula. If you know the formula, you can solve this problem. We will solve one more problem. Here also they are given the reciprocating engine. Yeah, they are telling us to find out the crank position and maximum unbalanced value. Determine the maximum and minimum values of the primary and secondary forces. Maximum and minimum values. Also, we have to find out their position. When we will have maximum secondary value? When we will have minimum secondary value? When we will have maximum primary value? When we will have minimum primary value? Those things we have to find. Here alpha value is 2 alpha equal to 60 degree. Okay, because angle between the engine is 60. So 2 alpha 60 means alpha 30. Then mass value 1.5 kg, write it. Then stroke, that is 2R. Stroke means 2R. Stroke value is 100 mm. So 2R equal to 100 mm. So R equal to 50 mm. That is 0.05 mm meter. Then length of the rod is 250 mm. Length of the rod is 250 mm. So L equal to 250 mm. That is 0.25 meter. Then speed. Speed is 250 rpm. So omega 2 pi n by 60. 261 radian per second. Now we will find the maximum and the minimum primary force. First of all, write the formula. 2 mr omega square cos square alpha cos theta. Put the alpha value. 30, no? 30 means, cos 30 means root 3 by 4. Cos 30 degree means root of 3 by 4. Okay? So, cos square means we'll get 3 by 4. Similarly, sin here they have to put sine. Instead of sine, they have mentioned cos. Okay, sine square 30 means sine square 30 degree means you will get the answer as root of 1 by 4. So final answer will be 1 by 4. Substitute 3 by 4 here, 1 by 4 here. Okay. So 3 by 4 cos theta, 1 by 4 sin theta. Now bring the, take the 4 outside. 4 is common. So take the 4 outside. You take the 4 outside. So when it come out of the root, it will be 1 by 2. Sorry, one. It will be getting like this. 2 mr omega square. Take 1 by 4 out. So 1 by 4. Square remaining will be 3 cos theta plus sin theta the whole square. This will be remaining. When the 1 by 4 come outside, it will be like 2 mr omega square. It is coming out of the root. 1 by 4 the whole square is coming out of the root. So it will be 1 by 4. What will be the remaining terms? Remaining 3 cos theta plus sin theta not whole square 3 cos theta square sin theta square. So 9 cos square theta sin square theta will be the answer. So 4 2 cut each other and 1 by 2, that's what they are given here. Okay, now when this value will be maximum and when this value will be minimum, that we have to find. Okay, when you put 90 degree, when you put 90 degree, cos 90 will be 1, sin 90 will be 0. So root 9. So when you take the 9 out of the root, it will become 3. Okay. So it will be the maximum value. Okay. sorry, when you put 0, when you put 0, when you put 0, when you put 0 here and 0 here, you have cos 0, 1. 1 square 1. So 9 into, that is cos 0 degree value is 1. Sin 0 is 0. Okay. So cos square 1, sorry, cos cos 0 is 1, 1 square is again 1. So 9 into 9, 9 into 1, 9. Here the entire term will be 0. Here it is 1. Okay. So when the 9 come out, it will be 3. Suppose if I put theta equal to 90 degree, means it will be the minimum value. Sin 90, 1. Okay, if I put 90 instead of 0, means if I put 0 means this term will be 1. If I put 90 means this term will become 0. The entire term, 0 into 9, 0. It will be 1. Sin 90, answer is 1. Yeah. So the answer outside will be mr omega square by 2. So 2570. So the minimum primary unbalanced force is 2570. Maximum primary unbalanced force is 7710. Now we have to find out the secondary minimum and maximum. We have to find. Write the formula. 2m omega square. Sorry, I forgot to put r here. So 2mr omega square into cos alpha cos 2 alpha into 2 theta. Here sin alpha, sin 2 alpha, sin 2 theta, the whole square. Now substitute the values. Instead of alpha, put 30. So you will have the value like this. Now we have to find out maximum and minimum. Okay, now we have to find out the maximum and minimum values. Suppose if we put 0 here means, sorry, if you put 0 means cos 0, okay. Here, if you put 0 means the entire term will be 1. The answer will be 1. If you put 0 here means the entire term will be 0. Answer will be 0. Okay. Suppose you have this answer. Okay. Suppose if you put 90 degree means, if you put 90 degree inside means, 2 into 90, 180. 2 into 90, 180. Here also 2 into 90, 180. So cos 190, 180, answer is 1. Sin 180, answer is 0. Same answer you will get. Yeah. So same. Even if you put 0 or 90, you will get the final answer will be 1. Here, if you put 0 or 90, final answer will be 0. Okay. So the final term is root 3. Divided by 2 m into m by n into omega square r. So the final answer will be 890.3 newton. Okay. So primary force is, primary minimum is 2570, primary maximum is 7710, secondary minimum and maximum both are same, answer is 890. That's all. So with this, V engine is over. In the next video, we will see about inline engine.